Hi, you're looking at the planter that was made with two plastic mill gallon jugs.
It's made of two parts. This part had a very mouth and neck of the bottle removed and the very bottom as well. Notice that I didn't cut the bottom out of the edge. I left about half, a quarter of an inch of the curved part remains. I like that, it keeps its shape easier. The bottom part handle was removed, but on the opposite side we kept higher walls, except at the angle itself where there's a 90 degree angle in the bottle, we cut that part lower, because if we didn't cut that part lower, there would have been some tilting when we insert this top part. But now it's fairly straight. The idea behind this setup is to have a planter that can do two things. First, there's a large area for planting. There's a lot of soil below. Second, it can hold water up to a level. If you want it to hold water lower, you just punch a few holes. But when you water this plant, assuming there is a plant there, the water doesn't just pass through and falls on the ground. It remains at the bottom and rises back by evaporation. Then again, this section is open, so the water level at the bottom will be basically the same water level in the planter itself. So we can either put rocks at the bottom or just leave it as soil. The roots will eventually find their way down, and that's the structure of the planter. Alright, I'll move on to show you where it all starts with jugs that have markings on it. Hold on. You can see the cut here. I can't see it, but I'm sure you can. You can get this out of the way for a minute. All around, the handle is definitely removed. The top neck is also removed. I'll come back to that because that's the most dangerous part of the operation, is removing that top section. And the other part, well, this whole top is going to go. This top is going to be removed, just the neck. Anyways, and just the bottom. So maybe it's time for me to start cutting. Hold on, please. Alright, in general, when cutting plastic, it is best to have a pair of scissors and a razor blade. The razor blade's job is to make the first cut. Don't go more than 1 inch. You basically want to have a space where you insert the scissors. And once the scissors are in, you continue the cut all around with just the scissors. Well, this one is a little difficult, so we may have to switch the razor back to the razor blade. So when the scissors have a bad angle, you go back to the razor blade. But there is a major principle involved here. Anytime you're cutting with a razor blade, you're applying pressure. and whatever you cutting is going to eventually be cut. It will give away. And that blade is going to travel in a certain direction. Do your planning in advance. Know exactly which direction the blade is going to travel. And the first rule is to make sure the blade doesn't travel towards you. So if you're cutting, if I was cutting like this, that's very bad. Because as I encounter resistance, I increase force, and as the plastic is cut, the blade travels throughout my body. And that's not good at all. You don't want the blade to travel toward any part of your body. In general, if you don't know exactly how to state the safety measure, just put it this way. Always have the blade travel away from me. Away from me. Away from me. Not towards me, away from me. But this time I'm going to have it travel not up or down. Well, if you want to let it travel away from you, make sure there is nobody standing in front of you either. But this time I'm going to have it travel down towards the table, just in case things don't go right. So it's like cutting butter, basically. But it's the direction that counts here. All right. It's very easy to cut, but it's very dangerous if you have the wrong direction. If the blade is aiming towards you, it's very, very dangerous. So I make sure it's handling, it's heading towards the table itself. Right. Now sometimes I'm at a 45 degree angle, but I want it to go, the blade to be going down all the time. Alright, okay. Achieve that, but that's the direction I'm driving it. See, I'm bringing this back, because if I leave it like this, I'll be traveling towards me. So I bring it back a little bit, hold it on its angle side, rest it on the angle. All right, and this part is done. Okay, the bottom has been removed. Now the harder part is that neck. So we'll do it the same way with the blade, and we're going down towards the table. Towards the table. And the good news is I never actually hit the table, but if I did, it wouldn't be a trip to the emergency room. Just be a little dent. Alright, and this is how we want to cut the part of the planter that's going to hold the soil. Alright, okay. Now I have some markings there. I can try to remove them, but once again, the angle is very bad for the scissors at the bottom. So that's the way I made this part. They look identical, right? Except this one, I removed the labels completely. And this one, you can still see some residue. All right, so that's the top of the plant. Now let's move to the bottom. For the bottom, that's more scissors friendly. So I start a little cut, right? As we discussed. And I insert my scissors, and here I go. The shorter the pair of scissors, the better, I think. Not to be fancy, it's not precision work. Here goes the handle part. That's it. It's done. With markings and all. Right here I have a little overcut, so I take my razor blade and cut it up. Okay. So these are the two pieces I just cut. This is the base, holds water. This is the top, holds soil. Stick one into the other, and here, voila. I got a planter. Okay. Look at the inside of it. That's it. Lots of soil. I'll plant this one when I come back and give you a final image. Thank you. Well, well, well. To show or it's all going to work, this is empty. I'll put some water in it. It's going to hold water, rainwater, up to that level. If you want it to hold lower, you drill holes, but that's the level. Cut below the handle is the lower level. Then I'll take this and stick it in. I can stick it in like this or the other way around. Here we go. Voila. So when you're going to water this thing, you can see the water level. How much water is at the bottom, clearly. And if it's indoors, that could be enough storage for you to go on vacation and back. Just add it all the way up to the handle level, and that's it. So that's how I recycle mill, jug, gallons to make perfect planters. Watch my other video where I use water bottles, 5-gallon water bottles, and that's about it. My swing beans are doing great. I got some tomatoes coming. I harvested tomatoes already in tomatoes that I purchased at the store. That's well grown in a greenhouse. That's the best deal. It was $10.99. It had 6 tomatoes on it, and right away you get your money back. So it's never too expensive in the springtime to buy tomato plants at the store that are short but have a few tomatoes on them. They are the best deal because you can, whatever else you plant, you can watch it grow taller and taller and taller and never really yield any tomatoes. Anyways, that's the story of today's planter. Good. Thank you for watching. Come back for more. Thank you. Bye-bye. She's it.